very much. You know, Noreen, you've been talking about that all morning, about exactly when are they doing this testing, and it's very fluid. You could do the testing, and 30 seconds later, things could change.
Absolutely.
Or where exactly it could change.
And that's why I've asked for continuous monitoring, because again, you know, if you see an elevated reading and you're not constantly taking readings over and over, again, the reading is only going to give you that snapshot, that brief snapshot at one point. But once you see that high level, you really need something to keep monitoring it to learn, okay, is it tapering off? Is it getting higher? You know, how long were we at this level? If you're only taking one test every hour, you know, you're really not, you really have no idea how long that area was exposed to that elevated level. And that is a big concern, because it was not mentioned earlier in the press conference that they had reached anywhere near that level.
All right, we got a question from Facebook. Russell says, what's the effect of benzene on people with COPD and emphysema? And if the person has to use oxygen, how would that affect or bother them? I would imagine if you get, if you're using oxygen, that could help to aerate your lungs.
It actually could help, but it is a severe respiratory irritant as well. And that is why, you know, I say, stay indoors, seal the door entries if you're in that area. And if even if you're not, but you are someone who's on oxygen and you have COPD, you are someone who is more susceptible to the effect of benzene. And right now, again, we're experiencing levels that we never, really we never experience in our homes, in our day-to-day routines, unless you're somebody who actually physically works with benzene.
Yeah.
And most of us are not those people. So that is why you have to be very, very cautious. You know, there are a lot of, you know, pulmonologists are getting increased patients.
Well, doctors are calling you right now.
Exactly.
They're texting you and asking you questions.
They're texting me because they know that, you know, I'm going to give them the good advice that they can pass along to their patients. Because, you know, you have specialized populations, and I know that they're saying most of us aren't in these specialized populations, but most of us in Houston do suffer from allergies.
Well, and here's the thing. The body is constantly under stress,
Absolutely.
And so when we say, again, I'm going to repeat what you always say, that
the dose
makes the poison. And so your body's under attack by something else already.
Absolutely.
And something else and something else. Now you add this to it, and that's what kind of makes things go haywire.
Right. Think about the tree spores that are really high right now. So you've got that irritant out there as well. That's a physical irritant now with this chemical irritant.
Yeah, your body's having to deal with it. Okay, we've been talking a lot about respiratory, but the skin, as we know, is the largest organ in the body, and it is a barrier that can stop things from happening.
Absolutely. So protect the skin right now. Everybody should be wearing sunscreen, male or female. But ladies, right now is the time to put on your full face of makeup. Put on your foundation, because your foundation acts as a protective barrier.
Men, if you've ever wanted to wear it, now's the time.
Put on your foundation, you know, match it up. Try to get the face to match with the neck. That's hard for us sometimes. But anyway, it's definitely the time to wear your makeup. And then when you get home, take it off, because the contamination is on there. And again, this is not the time for bathing, because bathing is basically getting in a tub of water, letting the chemicals soak off. Your pores are all open, and then the chemicals just kind of...
So shower,
exfoliate, scrub. I always tell people, shower. This is not the time for a bath. If you really need a bath, shower and scrub first, and then have your relaxing bath afterwards.
Yeah. All right. So when they say shelter in place, since that's kind of the scene of everything that's happened, and we know that, you know, you can't keep those things from coming inside the house. A lot of people were running their air conditioners that day. So the concern is, in fact, one of our studio audience members had this question: instead of sheltering in place, why not say leave for a few days?
I mean, if you have the ability to leave for a few days, that's amazing. But a lot of people do not.
Right.
There are a lot, I mean, a large population in that area that just simply cannot. And then right now, if you've got 11 ppm, you're exposing yourself as you're on the way out. So that's why it's important to shelter in place. It's not that you may not have the means, it's just, why would you expose yourself on the way out to a really, you know, high acute or a short-term exposure, when you could just stay inside where it's way less than what they're reading outside.
Yeah.
So that's why, you know, we say that. And now that I'm hearing that these higher levels have been detected hours and hours ago, you know, again, that's why I want to know what aggressive testing means. Tell us how often you're testing. Tell us what you're using. Is this just a VOC monitor?
Or
is it something specifically for benzene, like a BTEX monitor? That's one that actually is specified for benzene. And there are people around the city that have this equipment. Call them, ask them to use this equipment. If the city doesn't have it in place. DCEQ doesn't normally monitor that. I'm not trying to embarrass anyone, but we have so many people that will be able to, that would want to step
because
up and help.
Because of the community we live in, being the largest energy capital of the world,
exactly.
We know what we do here, and there are plants that have this kind of stuff to monitor. There's
absolutely.
Private industries
absolutely.
That do.
I mean, the right. heart of Houston. It's just,
we have a couple of producers here with young children,
okay.
and they came up to you
mm-hmm.
during the commercial break
right.
and thought, you know, our kids are at daycare right now.
Right.
Should they be going outside and playing, even though they're in Houston proper? They're not in Deer Park or in that area of concern,
right.
but...
Well, people are having symptoms around the city, and they are a very, very sensitive population. Mm-hmm. These young kids should not be outdoors. That's why I said, play indoors. Come up with something where they can run around indoors. I get it. You want them to go outside and have recess and have a break, but it's just...
The teachers want them to go outside and have recess and have a break.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah.
They do too. Yeah. But the fact is, you know, have a little mini field day indoors, okay? Just it's time to keep them inside. I thought 3 to 4 days yesterday, that was before these readings went up, only because I was worried about this type of situation happening. I pushed that out, you know, I'm like, at least 3 to 4 more days from now, let's not go outside and let them, you know, start running around and breathing in larger amounts of air, because as they run, you get in a larger dosage of air.
Right.
I mean, that's how the lungs work. You know, you need more air because you're running around playing. Don't let them do that. Keep them indoors. It is just not worth it. I was really surprised that schools in the area, even a few days ago, were letting kids outside to play.
All right. So. You worked with benzene, as you said.
Yes.
Is there a test that someone can take? Can you figure out what might be in your body? And is that mm-hmm. something that you would do regularly? Or can someone go in and say, look, I'm having all these types of symptoms I never had before, mm-hmm. or they think they're feeling it. Mm-hmm. Could you really find out how much benzene might be in the body?
Well, I mean, they can look for biomarkers for benzene in urine and blood, but really, again, if
high.
You're having the symptoms
yeah.
that they know are associated with benzene, and we know that there's an active event that is, you know, putting benzene into the air, we know that there's a source of contamination, then there's honestly no need to waste your money to do that. But if you want to do that, there are ways that you can do that. Really, but what you want to do is make sure that you're taking care of those symptoms and you're doing something to resolve it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
And the crazy thing about these symptoms is tricky, because it's not like one symptom
no,
from one thing.
It's not.
It's just anything that can upset the body. And the body's warning system is to basically
yeah.
have those symptoms we talked
it's
about.
It's a wide array, but especially to the respiratory, the upper airways, the nose, the eyes, the skin. If it's really high, then you're going to start to see central nervous system effects, which would be dizziness and mm. nausea, which I don't think we're going to see that. I don't
right.
think we're going to get up
but
to
if
that
you do,
level.
Go to your doctor.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you, Noreen. Let's